A warm welcome, dear children. I hope you all are good and doing your study well on time. Today we are going to start our new chapter in civics, that is Fundamental Rights Part 2. In the last video we have seen Fundamental Rights Part 1. Today we are going to look more fundamental rights that are mentioned in the Indian Constitution. So let's begin with the explanation. In the last chapter, we have seen fundamental rights. What are they? Which all fundamental rights are included in the Indian Constitution, such as right of liberty, right of equality, and right against exploitation, which we all have seen in previous video and previous chapter. Now, in this chapter, we are going to see some more rights, that is, right to freedom of religion. Next, cultural and educational rights, right to constitutional remedies. So, we are going to acquainted with these rights and we are going to learn that how these rights are useful to any of the citizens who are residing in India, which means कैसे ये rights हमारे लिए useful है जो India में रहता है, हम ये देखेंगे, मतलब इसके क्या क्या benefits है और हम इस rights को कैसे use कर सकते हैं. Okay, these are few more fundamental rights that are mentioned in the constitution. Now students, our first right is right to freedom of religion, which means we are free to celebrate or choose any religion as per our choice. मतलब हमको पूरा freedom है कि हम अपनी choice का कोई भी religion choose कर सकते हैं, उसको celebrate कर सकते हैं, and we can follow any other religion also. हम कोई और religion भी follow कर सकते हैं, हमको कोई force नहीं करेगा कि आपको यही religion follow करना है या आपको यही religion celebrate करना है. And as per our convenience, we can convert our religion also. और हमको ऐसा लगता है कि हम दूसरे religion हमको अच्छा लगता है तो हम उसमें convert भी हो सकते हैं. Okay? Because India, we know, is an important secular country in the world. We have studied it in the previous classes. But you must be curious to know what the Indian Constitution says about it, isn't it? It is included in our right to freedom of religion. According to it, each Indian citizen is free to practice any religion and to establish institutions for religious reason, which means we are free to establish our institution also. Okay, in order to broaden the scope of the right to freedom of religion, two things are not permitted. दो ऐसी चीजें हैं जिनको इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ने परमिशन नहीं दी है. दैट आर, नंबर वन, स्टेट कैन नॉट इम्पोज रिलीजियस टैक्सेस दैट माइट बी यूज्ड टू इनकरेज अ पर्टिकुलर रिलीजन. दैट इज, आर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन फॉरबिड्स रिलीजियस टैक्सेस. क्या किया है इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ने, रिलीजन पे कोई भी टैक्स को क्या किया है, मना किया है कि रिलीजन पे कोई भी टैक्स नहीं दिया जाएगा. जैसे हम बहुत सारे टैक्स पे करते हैं ना, बगैर रिलीजन पे कोई भी टैक्स नहीं है. नंबर टू, रिलीजियस एजुकेशन कैन नॉट बी मेड कंपलसरी इन एजुकेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशंस दैट रिसीव एड फ्रॉम द स्टेट, विच मींस. नाउ स्टूडेंट, नेक्स्ट राइट वी हैव कल्चरल एंड एजुकेशनल राइट्स, विच मींस we are having full freedom to celebrate our festivals and be a part of another festival also. That is why India is called a diversified country, and we are free to follow any other religion or festival as well as to enjoy whatever educational rights are there. We are free to select any kind of profession as per the convenience. Okay, now We can see that there is a great diversity of festivals, food and ways of life in our country. You may have noticed the differences in the different wedding ceremonies that you all are attended. All these things are part of our culture of the different communities. Our constitution has given the different communities the right to preserve their cultural uniqueness. Okay, हमारे constitution ने हमको ये right दिया है कि हमारे हर cultural का एक uniqueness होता है और उसको preserve करने का हमारे constitution ने हमको वो हक दिया है कि हम अपने cultural के जो भी है उसको क्या करके रखे, preserve करके रखे. According to this right, people are not only free to preserve their own language, script and literature, but also make efforts towards their promotion. They can establish institutions for the development of their language. Now students see, find out and discuss how many official languages are listed in the constitution. There are almost 22 languages which are listed in our constitution. Which institutions have been established by the Maharashtra state government for the further development of the Marathi language? A few institutions like the Malwani Kokni institution has been established by the Maharashtra state government for the further development of the Marathi language. Now students, our next point is right to constitutional remedies, which means all people in the law are equal. That means as a citizen of country, if you have committed any kind of crime or any kind of unethical activities, you are liable to get punishment. There is no inequality for injustice that is provided by the institution and provided by the constitution or by the law, which means in case of encroachment of fundamental rights, the Indian citizens' right to get judicial remedies is also a fundamental right. This is called the right to constitutional remedies. This means the constitution itself has provided for legal remedies in case people's rights get violated. So it becomes a constitutional duty of the courts to protect the rights of the people. Sometimes the rights that are guaranteed to us by the constitution may get encroached upon and we are not able to exercise our rights. This is called an infringement of our rights. The court considers our complaints, investigates it, and in case it is convinced that rights have indeed been infringed upon and injustice has been done to the aggrieved individual, the court gives an appropriate verdict. Here I have mentioned some instances of infringement of rights, which means arresting an individual without reason, preventing a person from leaving a village or a town without giving a valid reason, refusing food, water and medicines to jail inmates. So that is why our constitutional has given some rights as constitutional remedies. Courts has power to issue various kinds of writs to protect the rights of the citizens. Courts ने हमको बहुत सारे writs दिए हैं जिससे हमारे rights क्या हो जाएंगे, citizen के protect कर सकते हैं. There are 5 types of writs. Number 1, habeas corpus. Number 2, mandamus. Number 3, prohibition. Number 4, quo warranto. And number 5, certiorari. Now let's see number 1, habeas corpus. Habeas corpus means to have the body, and it is issued by to protect the personal liberty of an individual against the arbitrary action of state or private individual. Now next, mandamus. Mandamus means we command, and it is issued against a public authority or an officer, an inferior court, for enforcing legal rights only. Cannot be issued against president and governors. जो mandamus होता है वो president और governors के against issue नहीं किया जाता. Okay? Now, next we have number 3, prohibition. Prohibition means to restrain and to stop. And it is issued by higher courts to the lower courts to keep them within the limit. और ये कौन किसको issued करता है? Higher court जो lower courts होते हैं उनको issued करता है ताकि वो लोग अपने एक limit में रहे. Okay? Now next we have certiorari. Certiorari means law, and it is issued by higher courts to quash the order of the lower court. Difference between prohibition and certiorari is that the prohibition is issued at an earlier stage. Okay. Now last we have quo warranto. Quo warranto means what is your authority, and it is issued to ensure that the person holding a public office is qualified to hold that office. So students, these are various types of writs which our constitution has given us to protect our rights, and because of the fundamental rights are thus protected by the court, citizens are able to exercise their rights. They can fulfill their roles as alert, responsible and active citizen while considering fundamental rights. We also need to remember our duties. So In the next part of the video and next chapter, we shall study our fundamental duty. So student, here we will stop our lesson. We have finished our chapter number 5, fundamental rights, part 2. I request to all of you, please read the lesson once again and complete your notes as well. Take care. Bye bye.